moans and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek.
We're so sorry, skeletons, you're so misunderstood. You only want to socialize.
But I don't think we should. Cause spooky,
scary. Welcome, one and all. November 10th. I think I give you first little segment. Like I was saying, the wrap up. I'm not going to be doing any vlogging till December 1st, first part of December. But I think I give you a little bit of footage a little early and just start collecting stuff and edit it together. I wanted to give you a kind of a mini Halloween extended wrap up. We got out here yesterday, and as you can see, front yard is empty. We got the tents down yesterday, all the decorations are out. Got the gardens blown out, they still need a little raking. Front yard desperately needs mowing, which I'll probably get to either today or tomorrow. And you can kind of see the trail people walked going through the maze and where the different displays and stuff were. Been pretty busy here trying to get the Halloween stuff down. Front yard, other than mowing, is done. All the maze panel or wall panels are put away. Inside the house, the basement, my spare bedroom, and the attic have been de-Halloweenified. We got everything cleaned up. Still dealing with a little bit of haunted tent mess though. I've got a couple of things here which get stored in my shop. Some plastic, my Iron Maiden, five of the tents, what have you, that I cannot put away quite yet. I've been out here doing a little bit of work already. The last main section I have to do is my shop. And as you can see, it is a total disaster area. And the stuff out on the patio goes back there in my little storage locker. I got in here earlier and cleaned up the middle of the floor so I could walk in here. It's been a disaster. I'm going to spend most of the day working on that shop trying to get it cleaned. Now, upcoming projects. My next project after I get done with all this Halloween stuff is I gotta start getting the Christmas display set up, which is up in the attic. Probably gonna get started on that tomorrow. First Halloween project I mentioned in my update was more carved panels. And I went down to Home Depot to pick up 60 sheets, 1-inch thick sheets of foam board. They had 48 in stock, or supposedly 48 in stock. So I told them, oh, I'll take it all. And ended up with some free foam board out of it. They had 9 of the 48 sheets, so I ended up picking up 39 full sheets. But 9 sheets had come straight from the factory. It was sitting up on the shelf. And they brought it down, got to looking at it, and 9 of the sheets had been damaged. Someone had cut a 2-foot circle out of the end of one of the stacks, out of 9 sheets. And they were going to toss them. And they asked me, well, would you like them? We'll give them to you for free. So I said, yeah, I snatched them. I can't use them for wall panels. They're too short. My wall panels are about 7 foot tall, and the sheets are only 6 foot. But I figured I could use them for another project. But I've got 39 sheets in there, 4 foot by 8 foot, and 9 sheets basically, 4 foot wide by 6 foot. which I gotta get unloaded, and they're gonna sit on the patio for the time being, but I can't unload them until I get those tents put away, and I can't put those tents away until I get that mess in there cleaned up, which is my chore for today. But anyway, that's kind of what I'm doing. Halloween is almost officially done here. Hey guys, it's November 12th. We gotta give you another little segment. Halloween update, last couple days. I took some time off today from my other projects I had to work on these, and I'm still not quite done yet. But I started mapping out my tents and the haunt and what have you. And I do this every year. It's how I figure out, you know, what displays are going to go where and what I'm going to need for the haunt, depending on how big the displays are, what have you. What I use is some graph paper. And what you see here going across our front porch, you know, is a layout of our front yard, our driveway, and the various gardens in the that make up our haunt. But this map here I drew out is the placement for the tents. I've got my biggest tent, which is a 20 foot by 20 foot position, where it's always been set. The tents I move around are my smaller 10 by 10 tents, and there's five of them. This year, tents are a little bit different. We ended up, last year I had a 10 by 10 tent here, and another one butted right up against it here. We decided we'd split them apart. This one is actually moved 2 feet further back than it was this year, and we took its mate, instead of being here, we moved it down to here, right off the driveway. We'll hang my signage off of it, people will enter here and exit here. This tent here, I'm trying to remember right, if I remember right, I had it lined up with this one. Okay, it's bumped over. And then we've also got this one here. This one always stays in the same spot. Reason being, it's the oldest tent I've got. We bought it, back mid-90s or so. Framework's still pretty good. The canvas on it, it's got some rips, some tears. It's old. You know, seams are starting to let loose. We constantly stitch it up. We always put it in this corner here, and usually anything that goes underneath of it is something that can usually won't be hurt by getting wet. So, you know, because there are some leaks in that tent. But anyway, that's my first stage. That's the first map I draw out, is to where the tents are. Now, once I get to this stage here with these tents, I then go on to figuring out the maze. And that's the next sheet. This is the official blueprint for the haunt this year. We're going to have people entering here. My coffin door, which is the main entrance into the haunt, is going to go there. They'll proceed into the chain hall. But they're going to the chain hall. Now, the graveyard is still going to be on the driveway, just like it was last year, but we switched it back. It's going to be a little bit more hidden. The tent that goes right here is going to be hiding it. We've got our mausoleum display. We've got the graveyard over here. Then they'll come into here into our photo gallery and wind around, and our mirror display will be there. We've also got a little courtyard here, and we'll have our shadow boxes there again this year. There'll be a curtain here. They'll come in. The torture chamber is going to get moved over to here this year. So they'll walk through, and then once they get to about this stage here, there'll be another curtain, and we've got a longer cornhole this year. We've also designed it a little differently as well. Normally we leave it at 4 foot wide, you know, for the hallway. This year we're doing all 3 foot high hallways, except in key spots, you know, like the courtyard here, and then there's a little bit wider hall here, have to because of the measurements, and I'm not going to go into that. But anyway, they get through the cornhole, then they come in, hang the corner here into the spider display, pirate display, then into the spider display. And last year, the spider display and the pirate display shared this garden. We're giving the pirate display back its bigger garden. Spider display, on the other hand, is going underneath a leaky tent. last year it was the gypsy display. This year we moved the gypsy display back down in underneath the big tent. So they're going to come down out of the spider, wind through, and this will be all the gypsy display here. This corner and up to about here is going to be our ghost hallway. I'm going to be doing some small projects probably later in the year, picking up some stuff to go into that ghost hallway, because this year we only had like 3 ghosts in there. Need a little bit more than just that. But there'll be a curtain there, and then they get into our blacklight room, our sewer room, or as I call it, the cesspool room. It'll be all blacklit. We've got 2 big ponds in here, so it should be kind of interesting. After they get out of that, they go right into the witch display, and then the wind out, and then out the exit out here. We also have our big cat display, which is going to be here. The mausoleum is going to have the spider on it again this year. And then this corridor here is actually a 3-foot hallway that goes back behind the tent, so we can get, you know, like the garbage can out, the mowers can get to the backyard. That's going to have the coach in it. And then one thing we did this year is over here in this general area, we put up a piece of plywood and put our small cat on top of that piece of plywood. I'm actually going to repeat that again this year, but we're going to move it over the exit hallway here. And I'm not sure what we're going to do with the exit hallway yet. Still working on that. But those are the 2 main maps that I draw out. And so I know where the tents are going to be, I know where the maze walls and the displays are going to be, and then I can do my build list for this season, you know, accordingly. After I get to this point on my mapping, I draw one other map, and this one here represents, well, as you can see, it's similar to that map, except it doesn't have my fencing in here, it doesn't have the displays listed, it is just showing where all my partition walls are going to be. Now, I draw this one up so I can get a count on how many partition walls I'm going to need to do this year's display. I have a rough count. It's about 175 panels is what I've got built already, stacked up outside. And I can go through here. Each box on the graph paper represents 1 foot. I can go through here and figure out exactly how many panels I'm going to need for this haunt, you know, and then compare it to what I have stored up outside, and it will tell me, you know, well, I need like 5 more 2-foot wide panels, or 10 more 1-foot panels, or what have you. You know, and I can get those pre-made ahead of time and have them. So it's good to have that. Fencing, I've got all that new wrought iron fencing I made for last year's haunt. Shouldn't have any problem. I didn't even use all of that, all the panels I made. I had tons of panels. So I should be good this year as well, but I can also kind of figure that out too if I wanted to. Hey people, it's November 18th. I've been staying busy out here. I believe the last segment I shot for you guys was the foam board in the trailer. That trailer clear back there. And I also mentioned I was getting started on my Christmas display. And what you guys had seen so far was just I had gotten the eaves done. Well, it's been about a week, a little over a week. And I figured I'd give you a daytime glimpse. But I've got the Christmas display totally set up and ready to go. Of course, it doesn't look like a whole hell of a lot during the day, for basic reasoning, is there's no power on. And though we did do a test run last night with everything turned on to make sure everything was working, and it was, we won't be activating the Christmas display until the 27th, the day before Thanksgiving, is when the display normally goes on, and then it lights up every night all the way through New Year's. So get a full month out of this display. Had a couple of people come by last night while we were testing the lights and looking at it. But we've got our arch with the Noel candles leading up to our front door. That white blob on the bush over there is a polar bear. And our fencing. My wife, we bought the wreaths plain, and my wife went through and did up the wreaths this year. And you'll notice the fencing here is from my haunt. So we got one haunt-related item out here. And we got a roll of candy canes and a light-up Merry Christmas sign, which can be seen from the main road out there. And, of course, you got to have a Santa, and you got to have a Frosty. It ain't a Christmas display without Santa and Frosty. That's always been our firm belief. We're kind of known, our Christmas display is kind of known as the Penguin House. I started buying stuff. Originally, we just did lights around the roof and stuff, and I started putting lights on the trees, and, you know, it's developed over the years. But we started out collecting penguins, assorted penguins, and we got quite a few of them. We got a whack-a-penguin. It's like a whack-a-mole, polar bear beating up on penguins popping out of the box. We've got Jack-in-the-Box back there that has penguins popping out of it. And we got an ice snow fortress with penguins. A little penguin with some baby penguins. Lots of penguins. Now, if you, Hall Staff, Scuba Spook One, and some of the rest of the guys in the video chats know for about the last year, I've been talking about wanting to introduce Halloween into Christmas. In other words, having Halloween pay its respects to Christmas. And the one thing I wanted to do was those guys there. Three skeletons carrying packages. And there's a company that we've done business with before called Oriental Trading. And we got one of their catalogs, Christmas catalogs. And they had some elf costumes, everything from children's to adults. And the children's elf costumes worked perfectly. They came with the hat, the vest, and some booties to go on the feet. And we decided not to use the booties on the feet. But those have been out for a couple of days now. And neighbors have been loving them. They think it's really cute to have the skeletons bearing packages out here. Mailman got a real good laugh. He delivered mail to the house next door, came around the corner, saw me in the display, and then actually took a look at what I was working on and just died laughing when he realized it was skeletons carrying packages. Now, there are no lights aimed at those skeletons. The only lights are from the wreath, the displays around it, and the packages have lights in them too. And they light up fairly well, surprisingly enough. But anyway, that's our main project. Like I said, we had it all plugged in last night. It's all tested and ran. Everything works. It took a little over a week all in all. One thing that was surprising me is a lot of the lights needed work. A lot of burned out bulbs this year. Wasn't that many when I put them away, but was this year. But anyway, Christmas display is 99%. Done. I still have two minor things I need to do, which I'm going to do later. I'm taking a break from Christmas. One, you'll notice the outlet there. I need to come through here and all my plug-ins, I need to get my covers on them. We normally put an empty butter dish or something over the top of them with a rock on it to help protect them from the snows that we get. I've got to do that. And the next thing's in my shop, and I'll show you. Hold on here. Okay, the other thing I still need to do, and I haven't had a chance to do it yet, is plug the wiring up in here. Normally, I run you can see the lines out there on the grass, three of the lines, there's four circuits out there. I usually run them in through the window, plug them into various outlets in here. Each extension cord has its own 15 amp breaker. Okay, and then instead of coming out here every day to plug the things into the outlet, I go to our fuse box down in the basement of the house, and I just, you know, turn everything on and off by turning the circuit breaker on and off. And there's times where I get busy or whatever, I forget to turn them off and they end up being on all night. That eats up electricity. And I'd been wanting to get me some automated timers. So I went down, when I was down at Home Depot, I bought a few things, you know, garland and a couple other little things that we needed for this year. We were looking around and they had these for like 10 bucks. They're a digital 16 channel timer. In other words, you can program this thing by the day or groups of days. I think it is. You have it run for the full week, Monday through Sunday, and it'll turn on and off, you know, each day, whatever you have programmed in. Or you have it set for like Monday, Wednesday, Friday, or Tuesday, Saturday, you know, Wednesday, what have you. A lot of different features. I'm only using one channel on it. There are 16 different programs, though, that you can do. And I've got this set. I've bought four of them. And so all four circuits will have their own timer. They're all set to come on about 4:30. The first one will trigger at 4:30. The second one triggers at 4:30 and 15 seconds. You know, the time all four activates, it takes about full minute for all four of them to trip and turn on. Just a kind of like a little time delay. I gotta get those plugged in yet, and the cords plugged into them in here. So I haven't gotten to that point yet, and I won't until next week. Same way with the covers outside. Now, Halloween wise, you saw footage earlier. You guys know my display is down, and I kind of went through a very lengthy walkthrough of the sketch of next year's haunt. And I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but next year's haunt is going to have the biggest maze that we've ever done. We decided to do, instead of a 4-foot walkways, we did 3-foot walkways. And 3 foot wide, and that means we are going to have, time I got everything figured out, 294 feet of maze with all the displays hidden within for this next year. So it should be interesting. As to the foam panels, I'm not sure how much I went into detail on it, but I got all the foam unloaded, and I've got everything cut down to 2-foot width. Still needs to be carved yet. And this is only one section of the foam. There was 39 sheets cut in half. So be 78. I got 78 panels there. I originally bought foam for 120 panels. It was 60 sheets. They only had 39 in stock. The rest is on order. It's not supposed to be in until between the 20th to the 25th sometime. So I'm going to have to wait on cutting the rest of that foam until it comes in, which doesn't bother me. It's going to take me a while to get those carved anyway. But I've got to go get up in the attic, get one of my scene setters wallpapers down, because I was going to try to semi-mimic one of the patterns that we use in our Gypsy and a Witch room. And I've got some pictures, you know, from my vlogging and stuff, but perspectives weren't quite right for me. So I figured I'd get the wallpaper down. I can get a better look at it and figure out what parts of the wallpaper I want to use on my first set of panels. So I've got to go do that now. But I'm gearing up to get started on the foam carving. Also found out my college-bound daughter, actually, she's just about ready to graduate. She's got another year to go. But due to college classes and work and everything else, she hasn't been home for 3 years. You know, we see her quite a bit during the summer, which is okay, but we still miss her on during the holidays. I got a call from her. She's coming home for Thanksgiving. In fact, I'm going to be going over the Wednesday before Thanksgiving and picking her up, and she's coming home. But she called us, said, "Dad, could you come pick me up? I'd like to come home for Thanksgiving this year. I'm scrapping everything. I want to be with the family." So the wife and I are all excited, and that means we're going all out for Thanksgiving, because we're going to have our daughter home. So, but anyway, back out here with the Christmas. That's kind of where we're at right now, kind of what I'm working on. Fill you in if I have any more for you a little bit later. Okay, boys and girls, as you just seen, I've been shooting some footage off and on all month. And I know on my last vlog, I mentioned I was not going to be doing any vlogging until about the first part of December. Kind of hard to stay away from the camera. At least I haven't had to do a whole bunch of editing every week, which has been nice. But things are going to change a little bit here. We got Thanksgiving coming up next week. I've got all my Christmas, as you've seen in, you know, this vlog. I've got the Christmas display set up. I've got foam in for my first project for the season and what have you. Making a executive decision here. And of course you're going to know what that decision is already. I'm going to post this vlog before December 1st. Basically, to clear the camera. There was a lot of footage I did where I rambled a lot, so this vlog is going to be fairly long, and if I add this footage to the December 1st vlog that's going to be going up, you're going to be sitting through a 2 or 3 hour vlog, and I know some people, specifically like hall staff, ain't going to want a 3 hour vlog. So I'm going to bring this vlog to a close, and we're going to get this thing uploaded. My main reason too is the foam panels that you saw earlier in the this vlog. I'm in the process of cutting out some stencils right now to start my first prop for the 2014 season, and I want to start the first official prop vlog, you know, fresh. So I'm going to get this edited, get it uploaded. So I'm not sure when the first official prop vlog is going to be going up. It may go up here just prior to Thanksgiving, or I may wait till December 1st to post it. So you may have a week or two to go before you see another vlog. But anyway, going to bring this to a close, get this thing edited, get it uploaded, and say, stay spooky out there, guys. And here's a starting to the 2014 build season. Get it going, guys.